Hey there. I hope you're all well and enjoy Gatsby Conf so far. My name is Oliver and I work for SAP. Today I want to show you how we at SAP Community use Gatsby and ContentStack in order to provide a first-class content authoring and publishing experience. And you all know Gatsby and you probably know ContentStack. But who is SAP and what is SAP Community? Let's find out. So SAP, we are the market leader in enterprise application software. The company was founded in 1972 by the five former IBM employees that you see there at the top right. And the second guy from the front, who looks like he is in charge, he sort of still is. This is Hasso Plattner. He's chairman of the supervisory board at SAP. And he has been a great leader for SAP. We have a purpose. Help the world run better and improve people's lives. And how do we do that? We run the business transactions of over 400,000 customers worldwide. And as a fun fact, SAP customers produce 70% of the world's chocolate and 72% of the world's beer. Isn't that interesting? Now, I don't really want to talk much about me. If in case you are interested in connecting with me, you can do that here on Twitter. But I want to put a little spotlight on the team. So I'm heading the CXP engineering team. We build and run SAP Community. We are cross-functional. We have UX development, QA, and the operations part, the DevOps, all in one team. We are located in Minsk, in Berlin, and in Waldorf. And we try to live up to the Agile and DevOps principles on a daily basis. And we still try to have fun, as you can see in the pictures here. The team is amazing, and SAP Community in its current form wouldn't have been possible without them. So it's worth giving them the credits. What is SAP Community? Well, it started as the SAP Developer Network in 2003. It was quite novel at the time, at least for the enterprise space, to provide a public space where customers could openly discuss and complain about the problems that they have with our software. But it turned out to be very successful. People could write blog posts and ask questions, and others, customers, would answer them. So, right, plenty of room for connecting and collaborating with each other. The site, well, you see there, it's a screenshot from 2004. I got out of archive.org. Looks sort of dated. These days, it's a little bit more modern. But the basic ideas and the vision are still the same. So people come there still on a daily basis, a couple of millions per month. During the years, a million questions have been answered. 126,000 blog posts have been posted. And on a daily basis, 50 community moderators take care of all the moderation requests and questions that our users have in the community. And then there's also 240 content editors. They take care of topic pages and the resource pages that live on community.zap.com. And this is a key audience here for this talk now. From a technical architecture perspective, SAP Community, we have three core sites that serve most of the end user requests. Community.sap.com, this is where you find the homepage, search, the topic pages, additional resource pages, and it's also a place where we aggregate content and serve users and guide them into the other areas of the community. And there is also blogs and answers, and this is for publishing blog posts and posting questions and answering them. Then we collect all the end user activities and we send it into a Kafka message broker. And from there, it gets distributed into the various services and microservices that are there for quite specific purposes. So you can see there's one for search, but we also manage metadata centrally and subscriptions. So for example, maybe you want to follow a blog post or follow a question, and then you see all the content that you are following centrally in your profile. With that, we are providing a integrated, a harmonized user experience to our users. So how does now Gatsby and ContentStack come into play? In 2019, we were asked to provide a to renew the product and topic pages. So some were existing already, but there were problems. The content editors weren't really that happy. There were issues in the content authoring and publishing process. The pages also weren't really that fast. And we were looking into, okay, how can we improve that part of the community experience and really make the content editors happy again? We got noticed about headless content management systems, Jamstack. Michael from Graph CMS, he actually tipped me towards Gatsby. I should have a look into that. Maybe that would be would helpful to solve our problems. So we started doing research and also a little bit of prototyping. We were told, okay, in you have 10 days' time, there will be a demo to the content editors. And if we can come up with a proposal on how to solve that problem, we have 10 days' time. So we digged into it. Gatsby, when the team started using it, felt very natural. Content Stack, there was already a contact. Content Stack had been partnering with SAP on a different product. So it was quite easy there to get some form of sandbox instance to see how to make that work together with Gatsby. We took the topic page, we decomposed it, as you can see here, sort of identifying the individual components, things that already existed in our design system that we could reuse or new components we had to build. And then there was also that section at the bottom. It's recent question, recent blog posts. And there we said, okay, we can serve that from our Search API backend. And then there was the live preview part because we figured out, okay, in Content Stack, right, it's very generic. We need to provide our content editors a way to preview what they are going to publish into the productive environment. This is 2019 before Gatsby Cloud existed. And therefore, we built up sort of a custom Gatsby server that would run in this developer preview mode. And we found a pull request where a guy was introducing this underscore underscore refresh endpoint. We connected it with a webhook in Content Stack, and then each single time a content editor would publish into that preview environment, would just call that endpoint, and the web page would automatically refresh. And once we showed that, demoed that to the content editors, they really liked what they saw. It really seemed to solve a critical issue that they have and hit the head, nail on the head. So now, what did we present and how does it work today? It's pretty much very similar. For us, it was really important to fix the content editor experience, to provide them a low barrier into the content management, have it easily previewable, and then fastly deployed into the productive environment. And let me show you here on the right side. There's a little screen recording running now. This is a demo. So you see here, there's the area Ask the Experts. And now we have a Chrome extension. You click on that Chrome extension, that edit button shows up. You click on that edit button, and you jump into Content Stack. And you end up in that page that you just viewed. So now the content editor wants to change this specific piece of text. So he finds that specific content type, sees the text there. Right, ask your expert, going to be changed in Ask Our Gurus. Now, what needs to be done is just click Save, publish into the preview environment. So, right, we want to see how it looks later when it's being published into production. And we built a little custom widget. So, when that widget gets activated, there's just a button, go to preview. And this is opening our Gatsby developer instance on our custom server. And there you can see now it says Ask the Gurus. So cool, the content has been updated. And now the content editor can go in and publish that into the productive environment. All right, so end-to-end flow, really smooth. And this is what the content editors are using today. Now, there's another part. In order to keep the the content on the site fresh and also detect issues like broken links or misspellings, we use Site Improve. Site Improve is measuring these type of issues on the site and is giving us regular reporting. So once a week, we send out a report to all the content editors and make them aware of the issues that are there on the site. Again, a small demo. You see here, this is Site Improve, and now this is a page with all the broken links that have been found into SAP Community. So many of these topic pages, there are some links that are broken. We pick one, and there's currently two broken links on that topic page. Okay. So now inside Improve, you go into that page and you see already the links that are broken highlighted. Right? And now what we did a slight integration with Site Improve. And from Site Improve, you have that edit button there. You can jump directly into Content Stack again. So, right, and here, of course, the content editor goes in, fixes the link, yada, yada. But key is, and in most cases, the content editor doesn't really have to open Content Stack, right, start in the home page and then try to find the specific topic page that he's managing, that he's responsible for. What we provide the content editors direct entry points into Content Stack, and there guide them towards, right, publishing for preview and publishing into production. How is that being done? So and the Chrome extension from Content Stack just works the same way. There's a couple of attributes in the body tag. They specify the page ID and the content type, and that information can be used in order to build a URL, a target URL, and then jump from there directly into the correct page into Content Stack. That's what was being used from the Chrome extension, and that's what's also being used in Site Improve. So, what's the impact on the business side that we made with this? In the end, right, successful adoption by the editors is key, and we think we achieved that. So, this is a publishing queue out of Content Stack, and I used the previous week, and we just look at the amount of pushes into the productive environment and only them, and we have about 160 active pushes into production on a weekly base. And that's fantastic. So it has been really adopted well by the content editors. I told you in the beginning, they weren't that happy. There were many issues with the whole process. At the moment, they can do that. There is no involvement from any of the technical teams. It just works, and they just use it, and they don't complain. And that's already a big win for us. There are a couple of additional measures that we figuring out. So we use Site Improve for the quality measurements, right? You have these different categories: content quality, content freshness. That's really important for us. Security, it's serverless, so there is not really that much that can be unsecure. So we are scoring there really well across all of these categories, and actually consistently, significantly above the industry standard. And that's for us really important and a good success story. In addition, we run twice a year a UXI survey, the Experience Index, where we ask hundreds and thousands of users about what's their perception of the site? Why do they come there? And from that, we calculate these scores that we have around effectiveness, ease, and emotion, and then overall score. And you can see there that we continuously improved over the last 2 years this scoring. And I don't necessarily contribute all of that to the rollout of Gatsby and Content Stack, but I think we probably did we did our portion, right? We contributed our portion to it in order to improve these scorings. Now, from the publishing flow perspective, so a little bit more technical, how does it work? Right? Fairly straightforward. The authors go into Content Stack. They either jump there directly from the topic page or from Site Improve. They do their changes. They preview them on our still custom preview server. They publish into the productive environment, and then we have a Jenkins server there that's internal, so it's basically querying like every 1 or 2 minutes if there's any changes in the content stack environment. And if so, it triggers a build, a Gatsby build, puts the template, the pages, takes the design system code, builds everything into the full page, and then publishes the delta into the Amazon S3 buckets. The whole build for the Jenkins pipelines is around 5 minutes. So the content edits are very quickly able to see the changes in the productive environment. And that's also really cool. Good win. So I mentioned already the SAP design system. And this is a design system that we use at SAP Community and a couple of other SAP sites. It's following the general atomic design principles of design systems. We also use Zeppelin and Figma in order to achieve a consistency in the design and also to simplify the handover process into the development team. And that's working quite well. But then once we have the components, we build and test them in Storybook. So let me show you here on screen. This is Storybook. Again, right, we have these basic components, more Atom style, simple buttons. Storybook allows you to have these configurations via knobs. So you can change the text, you can add an icon, you can change the color. And this is working quite well for us, I have to say. This is a tag picker, so we have managed tags in the community. Here, this component is actually integrated with one of our microservices already in Storybook, so we can test that stuff here very well. Pagination is another component used across the site. So we have variants, like a simple one and a detailed one, and you can also enable editing. And then this goes into really building out complete layouts. So here you can see the question detail page, and we're using now all the basics and the components and build them out into full layouts. And it's quite interactive here. We are really trying to mimic the behavior of the site as much as possible. Now, what's interesting is how does it then get integrated into Gatsby? And with Storybook, in the end, we build node bundles and they just get imported into the Gatsby pages, into the templates. Right, you can see that here the bundle is com.sap.designsystem.community, and just with a simple import referencing all the individual components, we import them. So there is no copy and paste of code. Right? The full development and testing of these components happens in an isolated fashion in Storybook. And that really simplifies for us the development process and makes us more productive. Now, again, continuing with the technical part, so technical impact measures, and we set out the goal to really improve the SEO ranking and the page load performance. And I'm pretty happy with what we have so far, even though there is room for improvement and we know what we have to tackle and where we have to improve. You can see here, this is Google Page Speed Insights. And if you look closely, there's a parameter SAP TrustArc equals off. This is our consent management. And the parameter is sort of custom. We just built that in there in order to have realistic performance measuring with Google Page Speed. So if the consent management is active, it blocks all the third-party scripts. And then the performance is better than for a regular visitor that already consented. So we currently score with an 80 for a regular topic page. Again, there is room for improvement. We are working on that. Of course, just uptime is important, but again, so Gatsby and Content Stack, right, it's running on the community.sap.com domain and 100% uptime. There's no server involved. It's all just Amazon S3 buckets and zero downtime deployments. Yeah, quite happy with that. From a cost perspective, 300 gigabyte volume per month, roughly 25 million resource requests, about $300 cost. So from an enterprise cost perspective, it's pretty cheap, right? also super happy with that. So where do we go from here? Right, we started with these more static pages, but once we got a little bit more familiar with Gatsby and how it all works, we also figured out, okay, there is more that we can do. A couple of pages I want to present here. This is our community live page. So this is really an aggregation of blog posts and streams and videos that are being produced by our community developer advocates. So you can dive here, go into podcasts or videos from YouTube and just replay them. Right? There's easy filtering on the site. So it's just one way how we utilized Gatsby. So it's a combination of Gatsby and Content Stack. Now the next here is the our new topic page variant. So now this is one important feature here is that we are now multi-language enabled. So this page here is Chinese and English, but also we support a total of six languages. And then we have the integration again with our search backend with really nice filtering. So you can really drill down to a specific piece of content that you're looking for. This is the jump into search. And here you can just do have the same filtering capabilities, also personalization. So I'm logged in. The site knows where the tags that I'm following already, but you can also just filter down to any specific tag that sits in the site and then easily jump to the content from here. So Gatsby, right, it works really well for us. Content Stack also super cool, and we are just now exploring or continue to explore new use cases, how we can use it for the community in other areas, and it's sort of our first go-to choice now in order to build out new web pages wherever that is possible. Yes, so that's it mostly from my side. Just as a wrap up, you see here the two guys. Right. This is Gatsby and Content Stack. And by the way, this is in the background. This is a SAP event, SAP Tech Ed, and this is where the community comes together. And I really like that picture, the energy of the guys. And I just pictured, imagined this would be Gatsby and Content Stack. Right. So they're rocking the SAP community. It has been working really well for us. The content editors are super happy with the new content publishing flows. Our business is really happy. They got a problem solved, and the development team really likes how they can build new pages with Gatsby. Right? Our design system and Gatsby, that combination with Content Stack works super well. We are very productive with it, and yeah, it has been really a win-win-win. Yes. So that's it from my side. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy the rest of Gatsby Conf. And I think we are now going into a Q&A. Don't forget to visit the SAP community if you're interested at community.sap.com. Also, you might not imagine, but SAP is quite big in the open source area. So we have a page where you can find out what kind of projects we have open source at SAP. SAP UI 5 is one example, but there has also been lots of areas where SAP has been active, and all of that stuff is available at GitHub. And just as a slight note, there will be a fireside chat with me and the nice people from Content Stack and Gatsby on the 30th of March. And if you have the time, would be cool if you come by, have a look, and then I see you there. If you want to contact me, there is a couple of ways how you can do that. You can find me on Twitter or on GitHub, or you can send me an email. Again, thanks for watching, and have a great rest of Gatsby Conf. Thank you.